Hey there, Capricorn. Welcome to your reading for the week of January 8th. This week, definitely check out astrojar.com for more awesome readers and astrologers. But let's see what we get for you. And I'm smiling because you have the Three of Clubs, which pretty much everybody has had this week, which is crazy because I've been switching decks between every reading. So it's pretty interesting that it's coming up again. You also have the Ace of Hearts first. Yeah, great card for love. For you, I think that it mostly has to do with happiness and also kind of getting onto some sort of path. It's interesting. You have like these, the messages have been weird this week, definitely, I will say, for everybody. You have like these Spades cards, which normally represent difficulties. However, I'm kind of feeling it in a different way. I feel like it's like representing something else. I don't know. We'll talk about it when we get there. But, you know, I think that it's representing success. And you have two cards here in the middle that we're going to talk about in a second as well that I think are kind of representing just, kind of having just a clear vision of what you want for the future and getting there. So, again, I think there's this overall feeling of happiness. This card also, to me, represents, you know, to me, this is a good sign that you're, like, stepping out of something that's really uncomfortable. To me, this is, like, that complete opposite of, you know, having been in a period of being uncomfortable and not being able to get what you want in life, basically. Next, you show up here as a Jack of Diamonds. And the Jack of Diamonds is the only Jack in the deck that wants to be the king. And this is a card of you wanting to reach the top and be the king. The interesting thing is you have the King of Diamonds as well. And I think that, again, it's just showing the progression of where you will be this year. I mean, I know this is a weekly reading, but I really feel like this is kind of actually talking about the rest of your year. So maybe it's trying to get you prepped for the year and kind of like where you're headed in a lot of ways. Next, you have the Three of Clubs. This is a card of second chances and getting a second chance at something. Like I said, it's shown up for almost everybody this week. I think maybe like one or two signs haven't had it. And to me, it's a card of getting a second chance at something you want. And I think that for you, again, it's a second chance at life. Like, I mean, for you, for Capricorn in particular, I feel like it's something way more powerful than what the other signs have had. You know, for the other signs, I think it's just, you know, second chances at, you know, love or business or whatever. For you, I think you feel like you're getting like a second chance at life, getting a second chance at, you know, truly living the life that you want. Next, you have the Three of Spades. And definitely stay healthy at this time. If you can't tell, I'm breathing a little heavy. I got really sick last week, and I think it's really important to stay healthy at this time. Even last week, I was telling people to stay healthy, and I ended up getting this crazy chest cold thing. And I just think that for the next couple of years, it's going to be pretty easy to get sick because we have Chiron and Pisces. I've talked about this a little bit before. To me, Chiron and Pisces Chiron's a wounded healer, and depending on where Chiron is in your chart, it's in Pisces, wherever that is for you. That can definitely, I think, make it easier to get sickness and illness. Also, Neptune in Pisces as well. I think whenever we have Neptune in Pisces, it's just, it's easier to get sick from not taking care of yourself, from not getting enough rest, or something like that. So, Three of Spades to me sometimes comes up and says, just stay healthy, stay as healthy as possible, and, take breaks if you need to. If you remember last week, I was super late with the readings, and, sometimes you just have to take a break and just, allow your body to recover in some way. So make sure to listen to yourself. Next, you have the King of Diamonds. Again, this is you showing up here. King of Diamonds is Capricorn. Very good card with money. I've said it before. I think that Capricorn has great opportunities in life to be very successful, and has a lot of opportunities to make money in some way. So definitely a very good card for money. And this is a card of getting more serious about money. I would say that for you, that's what it's probably about. It's about getting more serious about your finances, getting your finances in order so that you can probably live a more comfortable life as well. Next, you have the Two of Spades, separating away from your old life. I mean, I put this card down and, kind of that little spiel I gave at the beginning of the reading about how I feel like even though they're Spades cards, I feel like they're actually kind of more positive. I think they're talking more about, you leaving behind the past and, like I said, going into that like Ace of Hearts type of life. So that's what I would say about that. And Eight of Spades, another card of taking a rest. This is a card that's sometimes called the Garden, and it represents taking a rest, having time to rest and having some place to rest where you can just take a break. So make sure to take your breaks. But Part of me feels like also that you're going to be really busy this year. So I think there's like a lot of busyness, and maybe that's why it's talking about resting and giving yourself time to rest as well. But it looks like a really good week. Like I said, I think it's only the beginning, for sure. So thank you for watching and enjoy your week.